2013 Toyota Prius. Listen, man, I heard you done got you a dime piece, man. Hell nah, man. One of them Beyonce making good types, man. Nah, nah, nah. Is that true, man? I just want to know. Probably not. I mean, shit. To be honest with you, man, she's a 2013E Toyota Prius. Caroline, listen up. Don't want to hear about your horoscope or what the future holds. Shut up, and let's get going with this stupid, silly car review. 2013 Toyota Prius. This car is a hybrid. A hybrid? What's a hybrid? A hybrid generally refers to any offspring resulting from the breeding of two genetically distinct individuals, which usually will result in a higher degree of heterozygosity. A hybrid in vehicle form is the combination of electronics with internal combustion, and well, what that results to is usually a fucking Prius. Toyota Prius, the official joke of the Gearhead's unobtainium universe of playing the villain and the hero in the umbrella business conglomerate from Toyota Motor Corporation. The Toyota Prius is a full mid-sized sedan, hybrid electric vehicle developed by Toyota and manufactured by the company since 1997. Initially offered as a four-door sedan, it has been produced only as a five-door hatchback since 2003. And before we go writing off this car's bizarre spaceship styling and odd quirks, let's just get things straight. The Toyota Prius, a car that, as it appears to the general population, is a failure, is honestly not a failure. Toyota has made millions, baby, millions of these Prii. I guess that's the plural version of Prius. Kids, go ask your English teacher what they think the plural pronunciation of Prius is. Thanks. Anyways, this is a 2013 Toyota Prius that is powered by a 1.8-liter 2ZR FXE inline-4 gasoline-electric hybrid engine and has a one-speed planetary gear transmission. The 2ZR FXE is an Atkinson Dyon cycle dual VVT-i inline-4 and makes 134 horsepower in tandem with the 1.3-kilowatt-hour nickel-metal hydride battery. The sensation one feels when they mash the accelerator to the speed of one long drone of white noise produced by the electric motor, and well, occasionally that four-pot does do something, but it's just a feeling of just some moderately intense encounter with the outer dimensions from the future.
Ugh, the future is now.
Yes, you feel some type of way, and whatever perspective you happen to look at that in today's world of gender fluid leaks and crossover obsessions, you might find yourself having peace and tranquility when you drive this car. The Toyota Prius XW30 was introduced in 2009 and was sold relatively unchanged up until 2015 with the introduction of the 4th gen Prius in 2016, and well, that thing just looks foreign and so anime-ish, we aren't here to talk about that. 2013 Toyota Prius. People talk more shit about this car than occasional subtweets about other humans making money and being successful by doing some outlandish whack-ass fun factory sponsored by Daddy's special little cupcake and a badge of Teen Titans taking over the globe. Even if you aren't a car person, when you hear the words Toyota Prius, that image of the space age high MPG perception joke comes gurgling back into a realm of existence known as lissophobia, or the fear of going insane. Oh honey, you're already past that point, you've handled much worse things before, and man, just look at that cheeky bastard smile and a face so conservative that the GOP even approves of its presence. The Toyota Prius is a car that represents the concept of convivencia, the unity, oneness, coexistence, and harmony with one another to exist and live peacefully together. I know, it's late in the afternoon, and you've listened to enough Rush Limbaough and Herman Cain talking points to destroy the minds of liberals and hipsters and millennials or whatever American psychotype of preference you choose your enemies to be, but just bear with me here. The Toyota Prius, in its most purest form, is a car that expresses so much angst and emotion that it shares a general misconception amongst all walks of life. From gearheads, to lawyers, to doctors, to engineers, to teen moms, to midlife crisis men, to teenagers, to stoners, to crackheads, to aliens, to the universe, and man, it just bears a pressure and presence that stirs up more conversations at Thanksgiving dinner with your fellow coworkers on being Mary John, and baby, can I get a piece of that Prius? I know a lot of this is objectively speaking, but I mean, will you just look at this? Look at that! Prius, hybrid synergy drive, clear LED tail lamps, hubcaps, eco tire, low rolling resistance, fuel tire, rear windshield wiper, this door, it really isn't a hatch, antenna, fog lamps, oh, and let's not forget this thing has projector headlamps. Yes, that's what aliens have, and daytime running lights, and the badge in blue to symbolize a color associated with intelligence, knowledge, calm, and concentration. Concentration, right, focus. Focus on the Prius. The Toyota Prius is a machine with so much over-engineering crammed into 3,040 pounds of mass that it's hard not to understand why recalls were issued on this generation of Prii. Yep, the Toyota Prius was subject to the 2009-2010 company's vehicle recalls for an anti-lock brake software update to fix brake response over rough roads, and also had cruise control issues causing unintended acceleration, which I could imagine being pretty fucking scary to experience in the event of something like that to happen. And it wasn't just the Prius that had recalls, nope. Camrys, Corollas, Avalons, Crowns, Matrixes, Siennas, Sequoias, Lexus, and Land Cruiser Prados were all subject to the giant Toyota Motor Corporation total recall. Nothing was safe any longer. I know, people rush to defend Toyota's reliability, and I'll be honest, they do engineer, design, and manufacture quality vehicles, but when it comes to mass market cars, they sometimes cheap the fuck out on some parts of the car. For the Prius, Toyota used a new range of plant-derived ecological bioplastics made from the cellulose in wood or grass instead of petroleum. The two principal crops are Kinoff, a member of the hibiscus family and related to cotton and okra, and Romie, commonly known as China grass and one of the strongest natural fibers similar to flax in absorbency and density. Toyota says this is a particularly timely breakthrough for plant-based ecoplastics because 2009 is the United Nations International Year of Natural Fibers, which covers Kinoff and Romie. Oh, how fucking ironic, huh? What a fucking coinkydink. How convenient, right after the Great Recession of 2008 and the destruction of America's middle-class families and the ever-bridging wage gap between the rich and the poor. It's almost as if the Japanese knew when to strike and, okay, moving along. 2013 Toyota Prius. A car for the early Gen Millennial who is sick and tired of being sick and tired of baby boomers mouthing off garbage into a pile of some vibe given off by the new MC on the block. According to a Rasmussen poll released on February 8th, 2010, Toyota is viewed very favorably by 22% of Americans, favorably by 59%, and unfavorably by 29%. Poll also found 72% of Americans have followed the recent Toyota news stories somewhat closely and 31% very closely. A second Rasmussen poll released on February 12th found 23% of Americans believe the federal government is criticizing Toyota to aid General Motors, of which it is the majority owner of. 38% disagreed and 39% were unsure. Those are some interesting statistics, but do they bear any resemblance to this big daddy GM? Didn't think so. 2013 Toyota Prius. It's an ostent victor in the perception department with those LED fog lights and conventional designated facial features oddly identical to a Domo Kundal. Japanese cars have a mixed reputation for many parts of the world, and the Toyota Prius is no exception. Here in the United States, we champion Toyota for creating things like the Supra or the Celica or the GT86 or 86 or just about anything else they make, because if there is one company that has its feet into everything, it's totally Toyota. But in a world of Nephilobotus, one who live in the clouds of their own imagination or dreams, or ones who do not obey the conventions of society, literature, or art, the Toyota Prius has to exist in this era of self-absorbance and discovery into the world in congruent shapes of jaded personality and the desire to have a worthy enemy in their life story. Personally, I'm not really sure why a lot of people loathe this car. I mean, honestly, what is so bad about this car? The looks might be something out of 2001, A Space Odyssey, or Interstellar, or Inception, or Limitless, or The Martian, or whatever, but if that's the car's only vibe, fuck the haters. So what? It's a hybrid, the McLaren P1, Porsche 918, Ferrari LaFerrari, Koenigsegg Regera. Those cars are all hybrids too. Yeah, we could get into how this car is not a supercar or hypercar, but that's not the point here. The interior is honestly eerily futuristic, from the gauge cluster to the maintenance required reset procedure to the hybrid generative information display to a parking button and a little knob to change the direction of travel, and ooh, you can change your measurements from metric to imperial, or who gives a shit? Unless you go cross country in this car, you'll never really use that button. It's got plenty of weird storage spaces, and all of the controls are easily labeled and easy to read if English happens to be your first language.
The mirror controls. Do you guys just use this on everything you make?
Yes. Yes, they do. Please, Google it. The side mirror switch is practically the same on almost every Toyota Motor Corporation product. How do they get away with that? Consumerism. Push button start because it's the future. Floating dash layout because it's the future. Infotainment screen because it's the future. Multi-button climate control because it's the future. Large glove box because it's the future. Where am I going with this? Oh yes, because it's the future. Let's take a look into the future for a little glimpse of the new Toyota Prius, eh? You see it? Take a good long look at it, because that's where we're going and there is no turning back after that. Centralized digital gauge cluster design, again another badge engineering tactic for different markets. This car isn't really badge engineered though, is it? No, it isn't, but the chassis is platform shared with roughly 33 other brothers and sisters under the umbrella of Toyota. Yikes, 33, that's quite a bit of pickings to go around. 2013 Toyota Prius. A car for the type of individual who eats at places like Chipotle or Willie's Mexicana Grill or Barbaritos or welcome to Moe's, or I don't know any other burrito places, dear. I don't get out much. 2013 Toyota Prius. The official car for having a prayer meeting with the other relatives about your father's choices and bridesmaids. Where the fuck did you get them at? A Sears closeout catalog?
Jeez, Dad, have some class.
But honey, don't put honey me, I will claw your face off with my freshly mani-pedied nails. Oh, it's that time of the month again.
Whew, holy shit-talking mushrooms with yum-yum sauce and Park Bugaki, because it's a Toyota and that means JDM, bro.
Oh yeah, I'm so Japanese domestic market, I hang domokuns from my tow hooks and stickers means more horsepower, bro. Oh yeah, I raced Dominic Toretto and man, I had you beat in the quarter mile, bro.
Hey, enough of that barbarian sausage chalk, back to the XGP9. That is an Outlaw Star reference for any anime fans out there. 2013 Toyota Prius. A car that writes more love letters to Julia and Highlanders than the average Nicholas Sparks character does in a Fortnite. 2013 Toyota Prius. A car for that special loved one that wants something with stellar fuel economy, and yeah, this car does get magnificent fuel economy. It averages about 50 mpgs, and if you hypermile it, expect 60 plus miles per gallon. Aerodynamics and eco tires and infinite number of gear ratios and hybrid electric power help contribute to those mpg ratings. Toyota Prius. A car name derived from Latin meaning first, original, superior, or to go before. But what on earth is this superior or first choice to? If the sights are a bit much, you could buy an Insight or Ioniq or a Prius Prime or a Prius V-Wagon or a Prius C-Compact or whatever suits your fancy, but if you want to be original, go buy a first-gen Prius. Totally underrated. The Toyota Prius lives in the world of atorexia, or a lucid state of robust equanimity, or freedom from emotional disturbance and anxiety. If you ask most Prius owners what they like most about their cars, the most common answer is how stress-free they are to own, maintenance wise. Yes, these cars do require synthetic oil, which can be expensive depending on what your interpretation of expensive things consists of. And those low rolling resistance eco tires do cost a little bit, but if those are the only main grievances found with the ownership of this futuristic spacecraft, then most people are willing to put up with that kind of drama. Other than those items of discussion, the only other issue down the road is the batteries, which, as proven by OG Top Gear, are not as environmentally friendly as the car perceives to be. A battery pack could cost several thousands of dollars if it was able to go bad, but this may not be around by that time. 2013 Toyota Prius. If Kanye West wins presidency in 2020, his first executive order is to ban the use of Prii and bad-mouthing Taylor Swift. She's just been through a lot, haven't we all? There. Hugs and kisses from yours truly. 2013 Toyota Prius. Ask your doctor which type of ED medicine is right for you, because you never know when you can seize the moment. Good luck doing that, though, in this thing. 2013 Toyota Prius. A hatchback sedan leaking more pink gender fluid than a social justice warrior does on Facebook groups called the Secret Society of Carp and Young Mothers of the Exceptionally Homogenous. I could go on and on about this car, but here's the moral of the story. The Toyota Prius is Tenderoni by Cromeo. Sure, she might have bona fide lovin' and fancy footwork, and when the night falls, don't turn the lights on, because this needy girl works it night by night, and I can't tell you why this hot mess is what you want and what you need, so just breathe and cross the dance floor future of Destination Overdrive and Rage with the old 45s and a sexy socialite, and you're so gangsta, Jay.
Put those legs over your shoulders, because the future is mine.
The end.
And it has, you know, enough power. It doesn't have, you know, a lot, just has enough. And, you know, that's okay.